Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summer, Gary Burghoff, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson and dear friends. How's everybody over here?
Good.
How about you?
You really got him agitated, John. Thank you very much for showing up and being so enthusiastic about the whole thing. We're going to have a grand time because these people are all charming and witty and humorous and talented and creative and all that.
Some of us are charming and witty.
Your chest is on fire. Beat it up.
All right. I'll beat out my chest. I see. Nice to see you again. We haven't seen you in ages. Where have you been?
No, I've been in Africa.
Oh, really? What were you doing there?
9 months.
Opened an Orange Julius store.
Country dropper?
My husband was doing Born Free.
Oh.
Gary Collins.
That's probably still on. It was such a good show. Is it still on?
Yes.
No, unfortunately, we're
I'm not surprised.
But it was great.
Welcome back.
The three of us went to Kenya for 9 months.
We don't want a whole bio, honey. Just where you were. Simple Africa.
They're all ready, so let's say hello to our one player here, Terry Ferreri. There's two of Terry Ferreri. When time ran out last time, Terry just won a game, right? And we're going to start with the audience match, and you're going to have a go at over $5,000. Are you ready for all that, Terry?
Sure am.
Okay, we'll get to you in a minute or so right now this. Here we are with Terry Ferreri. Now, are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay. You're not nervous, are you?
No.
We polled a recent studio audience, Terry, and we got their best response to this. Made blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, if you match it. Now, if you match the next one, you get $250, and the third, $100. Whom would you like some help from whom?
Betty White.
Betty White.
Maid of Honor.
Maid of Honor. There's one.
Richard.
Richard?
Present.
Yes. She wants to know if you have an answer to that film.
Oh, I do, yes. Do. Robin Hood, the gentleman that made Marion.
Made Marion. Right. All right. They went together for a long time, didn't they?
They were good friends.
Yes.
Okay, Marianne.
And Marianne Mobley. What do you say?
Oh, wouldn't you know, he got mine.
Well, say made in Japan.
That's terrific.
You want to say that?
Yes.
How about made in Africa?
All right.
No, all right,
now she's going to say made in Japan.
Yes.
And so there are your three choices, Terry. Made in Japan, made Marion, and made of Honor. You can, I don't think she got it yet. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I think I'll have to go with Maid of Honor.
Maid of Honor. All right. Come on, Betty, baby. Let's find out if it's up there. And if it's there, where is it? I ask you, is it under the $100 response? No, it is not. Maid service.
There's. Oh, that's what I love.
Really? Yes, of course. All right, looking for Maid of Honor, here's the $250 response. Maid Marian is the answer Richard gave you.
Robin would be very happy.
Last chance for Maid of Honor. Here is the $500 response. Maid of Honor.
I think we'll need one.
Yes. You really do have a piercing scream, my dear. I can hardly wait for you to win the $5,000. Okay, you're going to have a go at the $5,000 now, but remember, you got to match one celebrity head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Betty White.
Okay, Betty, you got ready to write, and you face me. Stand back a little bit.
Thank you.
And are you ready for this? I'll stand over here. Just in case you win.
Deaf in both ears.
Yeah. Here we go, Betty. Cross blank. That's C-R-O-S-S, blank. Cross blank. cross blank. Ready? Betty is ready. Now, Terry, we need an answer from you which you think will match hers. What do you say to that? Cross?
Bearer.
Cross what?
Bearer.
Cross bearer.
Very good.
You thought that was
naughty,
good?
Naughty.
The audience
obviously
didn't
not
too much.
Religious maniacs.
That's right. All right, Betty White, she says cross bearer is the answer that will match you. Is she right? We'll find out right now as you reveal your answer.
Cross my heart.
Aww. Cross my heart. No commercials, please.
I just know.
Okay, thanks. Three people got it, but what the heck? You can't win them all, can you? Well, listen, Terry, you've got your $600. You're going to play another game now. And let's bring on your challenger. Here comes Carol Hanna. Hi, Carol. You know Terry? Now we're going to find out a little bit about Carol Hanna. How are you today?
Fine.
What else you want to tell us about yourself?
Well, I live in Reseda, and I have three beautiful children, and my darling one sister is with us today, and my girlfriend and her daughter. I take Spanish class on Thursday evenings, and I go to a health spa.
You take Spanish?
Yeah, a little bit, you know.
At the health spa?
Un poquito. No.
Oh.
Not quite.
Another place there.
And I'm a regional sales manager for a car rental company.
Bueno.
You know,
that's it.
Janeiro.
Yes. All right. Mucha suerte. Is that right?
How dare you.
Anyway, we'll begin. Shall we begin? Here we go. Would you make a selection, please?
B for Benjamin, please.
B for Benjamin. Who's he?
My boyfriend.
Oh, that's your boyfriend. Okay.
How many children does she have?
Two.
Three.
Three.
She has three. I wish you have gone deaf from that girl shouting in your ear.
Mickey, I really can't hear. I really cannot hear. I think
you're not saying anything worse than hearing anyway.
Why don't we stop the tape and let Bert take over the show?
All right. I'm happy to help you.
No.
That's a beautiful suit.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you can't see.
Mickey Mouse said.
Just read the title of the show.
Mickey Mouse said.
Yes.
Hi, Minnie.
No, he said. I just turned 46 years old, and you know I haven't had a good blank since 1959. 1959 was the last time I had a good blank. Mickey Mouse
was
said
that. Mickey Mouse who said that?
Mickey Mouse said, I just turned 46 years old, and you know I haven't had a good blank since 1959.
You know, I like that voice on you better than the regular one.
I love your imitations. I think you're fabulous.
Thank you, my dear. What are you doing after the show? No, not right now. That's enough. I haven't had a good blank since 19...
That's right. Aren't we going to Encino? Have I done something to offend?
Right
to
Encino.
Listen, you gotta take her. She's got her real hair on tonight.
No. Is that your real hair?
Is it? And you know something? It sheds more than the wigs.
No kidding. Okay, she's all set.
I had to wear black.
All right. Come over here to Carol and ask her. Mickey Mouse said, I just turned 46 years old, and you know, I haven't had a good blank since 1959.
Loving.
Good loving? Really? She says, Mickey Mouse hasn't had a good loving since 1959. I don't know what that means, but we'll leave it up to our judge to figure it out as we reveal the answers.
Well, I think I know what she means, and my answer shows you where my priorities lay or lie. I said a piece of cheese.
A piece of cheese. I had a good
not quite as important as a good loving, but I'm not okay.
All right.
That's not a match?
No, that's not a match.
No.
Brett?
They're not the same game.
No.
American cheese?
No, cheddar.
What's the difference?
Swiss. Well, I said, this may be a match. Now, there may be another. I said, oh, heavens, I said girlfriend. Actually, I meant girlfriend.
Girlfriend.
I haven't had a good
I left out the
end. Girlfriend.
Yeah, I've seen your dates.
All right, it's up to you now. She's looking for the answer
up
loving.
To me.
Yes.
I hope not. I said picture.
Haven't had a good picture. Haven't made a good movie.
Oh, you're always
Mickey Mouse
said,
I just turned 46 years old, and you know I haven't had a good blank since 1959. What do you say, fresh back from Africa, new to our ways in this country?
Right. I am so new to your ways in this country that I thought he's getting so old.
He's having trouble chewing. He hadn't had a good meal.
Haven't had a good meal since 1959. All right.
Hi, I'm Mickey.
Hello there!
Fly me to Miami.
I happen to know he hasn't had a good piece of cheddar.
Since 1959. All right. No cheese. Carol, you're looking for the answer loving. What are you offering? Piece of cheese. All right. So none for you. Your question coming up, but right now, this for you. All right, now we go with the other half of round one. Terry, this is for you. The NBC executives fired Michael Landon when they discovered that the Little House on the Prairie was a blank.
Got it.
Did you hear that, Terry? The NBC executives fired Michael Landon when they discovered the Little House on the Prairie was a blank. Yeah. Now, we're waiting for
I'm
two bodies up here.
I'm ready and waiting for the rest of this moldy group.
All right. Okay, everybody's ready. Terry Ferrari. The NBC executives fired Michael Landon when they discovered that the Little House on the Prairie was a...
barn.
A barn? All together.
Boy,
we just wanted to make you
show.
Feel good. Okay, she says the Little House on the Prairie was a barn. What'd you say, Bert?
Well, I was thinking it was a Western. The first thing I was going to say when they discovered the Little House on the Prairie was a fire, because that's how you say it. But instead, I said a bordello is what
hey,
I said.
Hey, bordello, all right. What'd you say?
Someday he'll learn to take my advice. I told you not to do that fire joke.
Oh, sorry.
It was nothing.
Don't pick on me. I'm new here.
I said brothel.
Brothel. That seems to be the answer, Terry. That's
Isn't
come up
that
twice
funny?
Now, Gary.
Brothel.
I didn't even think of those answers.
You didn't?
It's incredible.
Why not?
I don't know. She's dressed in red. I didn't even think of it. I said a tenement. I didn't know what I was saying.
A tenement. Yes.
Oh,
well, he had to say something.
Right. That's right.
What did you say?
Well, as my 80-year-old grandmother would say, who's in the audience today, they was a house of ill repute.
Is that what Granny said? Is that what you say? Yep, she just said it.
That's what Manny would say.
What do you say?
Well,
what
as my 80-year-old grandfather would say if he were here in the audience, but he's not. He happens to be at a bordello.
I see.
He said the time just flies away.
Yeah. Well, we've had it five times so far, Terry. Do you make it six, my dear?
No.
You don't?
No, I don't, because if my grandfather were here, and he's not because he's out back, a kadooey.
A what?
A kadooey.
A kadooey.
A kadooey is as in Biffy.
Oh.
Your granddad didn't know how to talk too well, did he, Betty?
I'd like an explanation of that damn question. It's
amazing. She married a word person, too.
That's all right. I understand.
If you don't dig these intellectual answers, I can't help it.
Okay, I'm doing the best I can.
Jean, her husband, host password, and her grandfather didn't even know how to talk.
Trained him. All right, Carol, would you please make a selection as we begin round two?
I'll take B again.
B again?
B
Everybody plays again.
Again.
B again.
Thank you very much.
I have two of them up here.
Just leave an 8x10 glossy and we'll play.
Someone else.
That's an 8x10 glossy.
Attention, please.
All right, here we go. Count Dracula said,
I am going today to the big league baseball game. I am going today to the big league baseball game because today is blank day.
Count Dracula said, I am going today to the big league baseball game because today is blank day.
You sound like Dracula's a sissy.
Now you know why I went around sucking blood.
I don't understand the question.
I'm going today to the big league baseball game because today is blank day.
Finish. Come on, write something.
Well, even Betty White, who usually is as quick as a flash.
You don't understand this, do you?
I make a baseball answer, which I don't know anything about baseball.
Of course, there's an answer to.
I could say backstroke today and pretend it was a swimming question.
Because today
I'm absolutely amazed.
I'm going today.
I don't know. Oh, I got it.
Today.
That's it. Oh, I don't know anything about baseball.
Don't give it
I don't even want to see a ballet about baseball.
They don't do too
did
many
of those.
Did you finish,
Mike?
I wish I hadn't, but I finished.
Let me just...
They did a ballet about your voice last week.
They did?
Mm-hmm. Everybody right. fell in the orchestra pit.
Oh, dear. I haven't had such a hot answer since I said Benedict Canyon.
All right, Carol Hanna. Count Dracula said, I'm going today to the big league baseball game because today is blank day.
Vampire day.
Vampire day. I think she did not understand the question either, like they did not. She says, vampire day, Bert.
He went because it was bat
That's
day.
That's the answer.
No? That's not the answer? Yeah, all right. What do you say?
This is going to come as an enormous shock to you. Be prepared. Hang on to the side of the building. I said bat day.
Bat day. Very good.
Now, it didn't match vampire, but...
No, too bad. Gary.
Said umpire, vampire. That was a good answer. I said bat, though. I'm
bat.
Sorry.
Okay. How about you?
How about me?
Yes, that's what we're all saying. How about Marianne Mobley?
I hate those clever people who say bat day.
Yes.
But you know they have ladies' day.
Yes, they do have ladies' day.
Right. They do have ladies' day, and on this particular ladies' day...
Oh, get on with it, Marianne.
Don't rush me.
I hope you got
vampire
there.
They were also taking blood. So it was Ladies' Blood Day.
Ladies' Blood Day.
All that for that?
Well, right. In all fairness, suddenly mine doesn't seem quite as bad.
Well, it is still pretty bad.
Oh, it is awful.
As you'll find out in a moment.
Oh, yes, you're right, you're
blood,
right.
Was on blood the Donor's track. Day.
Donor's Day.
There's an American who didn't understand it.
That's right. All right.
But listen, I think I have a match. I really think I have. I said Bat Boy Day, and a Bat Boy is a short vampire, right?
No. You changed your mind, didn't you? No? Oh, I see.
Well, maybe they'll give me one for donor.
So it's 1-0 in the middle of round two here, and your question's coming up in a moment or so, but right now we got a message for you. This is it. Here we go. Second half of round two. You need 1 to tie, Terry, 2 to win. Let's have a go at this, shall we? Everybody plays. Sitting Bull say.
Yes.
He do.
Ah. Oh. Mm.
Ah. He don't defend any Indian. Just read the question.
Crazy horse, heap crazy.
Pardon?
When me tell him, let us bury hatchet, him bury hatchet in blank. Sitting Bull say that. Crazy horse, heap crazy. When me tell him, let us bury hatchet, him bury hatchet in blank.
I got it.
Okay. All right.
Wait a minute.
Here we
I'm
go.
Ready. I'm
We're
ready.
Ready.
Yes.
Now, Terry, Sitting Bull say crazy horse, heap crazy. When me tell him, let us bury hatchet, him bury hatchet in...
Scalp.
In scalp. Okay. Little Indian girl say scalp. What do you say?
I say, I think same thing. Him bury hatchet in me.
Me. No.
No.
No. No match.
I go on warpath now and kill.
Kill him.
Not unless you have a scalp on your knee.
Well, it could have been, you know, it could have got it in the thigh or in the toe or someplace else.
Or in your arthritis.
You gotta watch your toes.
That's right. What do you say?
Oh, honey, you know what I said. You know how smart I am. I said my head, which is
a head. All right, there's one match. One more head. When's the game
for honestly,
her?
I really meant head. I said war bonnet, but that's what I meant.
You said war bonnet. What about that?
Oh. No. I don't know
if I lied. Don't missed, that wasn't you could have missed the scalp sir. There. What do you say?
Now, honey, don't worry. Because if you can see, I just left Sitting Bull, and he said, in my head.
Head wins the game. What do you got there? Head. Head. Come on, Congratulations to you. Another $100 for you. You stand by for a moment. We've got to say goodbye to Carol Hanna. I'm sorry to see you go. We've got a gift for you together with our thanks. Goodbye,
thank
Carol. Now, you're going to have another go at it here. You know how it goes. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Nobody's blank. The answer they gave, you know, is worth $5, $250, and $100. Whom do you want to get a little help from?
Bert.
Oh. What do you say? Nobody's...
Nobody's perfect.
Nobody's perfect.
Okay. Brett?
Nobody's sweetheart.
Nobody's sweetheart now. That's a song, yes.
Okay, Richard?
Richard.
Nobody's business.
Nobody's business? Yeah, nobody's business, nobody's sweetheart, and nobody's perfect. You want one of those, or do you want to give us one of your own?
I'll go along with nobody's business.
Nobody's business, the one she's looking for. And let's find out if it's under the $100 response. Nobody's perfect is there.
Yay!
Let's see what's under the $250 response. Nobody's business is the one. You got it. Congratulations to you. There's another $250 yeah. for you. You're up to $950 now. Stand by for a moment or so. We got to do a little business
what's
here. I'll tell you later. Nobody's... In case you didn't see it, the thing under the $500 response was nobody's fool. And
you can say that again.
All of these foolish people will return again tomorrow.
Same to you, fella.
For another session of Match Game 75. Gene Raven here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production. Stay tuned for Title Tales next over most of these CBS stations.